Hello, all my dear Virgo friends. I hope you're doing well. This is Maxine Taylor, and I have your January 2021 forecast right here. I can't wait to share it with you. Let's start with Mars, the red planet. Mars is action, it's energy. It has been in your eighth house of secrets and joint finances, and all things that need to be investigated and uncovered. The psychic detective in you has been alive and well. And so there may have been some frustration over mutual financial projects. I'm happy to say that on the 6th, Mars moves into your ninth house, which is the big picture, and you see opportunities that you didn't realize you had before. First, you have to work through any frustration, maybe even anger, because Mars is what we fight with and fight for. It's what comes first to us. And so getting those financial projects handled, very, very important. Then when Mars is in your ninth house, you're ready to spread your wings and soar. I know you'll be ready to travel. I don't know how advisable that is in view of COVID. Everybody, of course, has to make up their own mind, but you can travel the internet. You can take a trip without leaving the house, essentially. And because you're able to reach out, stretch out, extend your reach, do it. You got the green light. Now, Venus, the pink planet, planet of love and beauty, wherever it is, it blesses you. It's in your fourth house of home, family, and real estate. And so there can be situations that are very beneficial when it comes to real estate matters, home matters, or even loving family members. I love that. On the 8th, Venus moves into your fifth house and you are ready to play. I don't know what your favorite outlet is. Maybe it's movies, maybe it's books, maybe it's having virtual dinner with friends all over the world. Remember that ninth house is triggered and that's foreign places. So enjoy after the 8th, enjoy, play. Did I mention enjoy yourself more than three times? Because it's really the time to do so. Now, the sun, the giver of life, has been sitting in your fifth house. By the way, if you have kids, you'll be able to spend more pleasurable time with them because of Venus. And I just in general have fun with people. With your fifth house activated, it's time for fun. I don't want you to think you're not going to be working because you will. All right, so with the sun in the fifth house, party. Enjoy yourself. On the 19th, the sun moves into your sixth house of work, health, and service. And what you're going to find is that your job picks up. You can have more authority at work. And so many people are working from home. And so you can establish yourself as the leader on the job, depending on your situation. Mercury, the blue planet, that's what we think about and talk about. And there it is in your fifth house. You're enjoying yourself. On the 8th, it moves into the sixth house and prepares the way for the sun. So you're thinking about your work. You're talking about it. You may be planning a whole new approach with the projects that you're doing. Super. But this is the area that will pick up. So you're and pick up speed, and you'll feel very good about it. By the way, the sun is the giver of life. And so if you've had any health issues, they can improve with the sun in your solar sixth house. Now, Mercury goes retrograde on the 30th. it moves into the shadow of the retrograde on the 15th. So at that point, you may feel like Mercury is retrograde. It's not, it just feels that way, because that's how it feels in the shadow. And we have one shadow before it goes retrograde and the second one after it goes direct. Join me next month and we'll talk about it. Now, we've got a new moon and a full moon. The new moon is on the 13th in your fifth house of fun and games. It's in 23 degrees of Capricorn. Find 23 Capricorn in your birth chart and combine it with this solar chart for the total picture. It's time to, the new moon starts energizing things. Energy starts moving forward on the new moon. And so you're ready to play for 2 weeks. Then on the full moon, which is on the 28th in 9 degrees of Leo, you're saying, I got to pull back. I got to retreat. I got to get my ducks in a row. Go away, world. I need to do my thing my way, away from prying eyes. Cool. Do it. Alert people. Say, look, I love you. I just need some time alone. And you know what? People understand that now. I've found us to be a more loving, caring, understanding group than I ever thought we could be. So that's the way your forecast looks. Please join me next month when once again I take a look at your forecast. Until then, may the stars shine brightly on you and yours. Bye for now.